Welcome back to our course on Project 2013. In this section, we're going to take our first look at resources. And by resources, I mean things like the people that are going to work on our projects, the materials that we're going to use, and the equipment that's involved in building this house. There are some other types of resource that we'll look at a little bit later on in the course. But for the moment, for our house build project, we're going to concentrate on the people and the materials and the equipment. Now, when you're looking at a Gantt chart, which is a view in Microsoft Project that most people use an awful lot of the time, you're basically looking at the tasks involved in your project. If you want to look at the resources, there are a number of views specifically related to resources. Now, if I click on the button below Gantt chart there on the task tab on the left, click on that, I get a list of available views, and one of the available views is resource sheet. And we click on resource sheet first, and we'll see a list of the resources that we currently have on our project. Note with the view that you've got a label on its side down the side, just reminding you which view you've got. You've got the resource sheet view. And another thing to note is that down at the bottom, at the right-hand end of the status bar, as I mentioned earlier on, you've got some buttons to switch between the most commonly used views. Now, the button on the left, the first one of those, the one that's highlighted at the moment, is Gantt chart. So to switch back to Gantt chart, I can just click on that. And the one three to the right of that is the resource sheet view. So if I click on that, that switches me back to resource sheet. They're two of the views that you're going to use the most while you're working with Microsoft Project. Now, let me set up some resources. And one way of setting up resources is to set them up in the resource sheet. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is to define a resource called bricklayer. Now, a bricklayer is a person who lays bricks, and whenever there's some bricklaying to do, I'm probably going to assign a bricklayer to a task. Now, it's very important to recognize here that I am not talking about a named person. This isn't the bricklayer called John Doe or Jane Doe. This is a bricklayer in general. And there are some situations, perhaps in longer term planning, where I may use a resource of bricklayer, knowing that I need a bricklayer, but I don't know specifically which one yet. And there are some situations where I may assign an individual person straight away. But more of that later. For the moment, we'll just say bricklayer. The next thing we need to do is to click into the next field, which is type, and select a type. Now, in many ways, this choice is the most important one of all. There are basically three resource types, although there is a special case that we'll talk about later as well. But with those three resource types, it's very important that you assign the correct one. Now, as soon as I put the cursor into this type cell in the resource sheet, you'll see that a number of other fields got values on the right there. Many of these are related to costs, and we're going to talk about costs later on, so I'm really going to ignore the cost ones for the moment. But a couple of these fields are important. One of the ones that's important is max, and the max field says, what's the maximum number of this thing that we have available? Now, we'll talk about maximum amounts and availability and so on later on as well. But at the moment, 100% means we've got one of these things. We've got one bricklayer. So when we come to schedule the building of the house, having only one bricklayer may well turn out to be a very important thing. Now, another one of these cells which is actually quite important is the initials cell, because initials, although it doesn't really affect any of the calculations and so on that we're going to be doing, it does appear in a number of places, particularly attached to the Gantt chart, and it's useful here to have a good abbreviation for the resource that we're talking about. So I'm going to put as my abbreviation here Bricky. Now, that's a British abbreviation for bricklayer, but I think it's probably used fairly widely around the world as well. Let me just point out here that I've got the entry bar when I'm working here on the resource sheet, so I can type in there. The abbreviation is going to be Bricky, tick it, okay. Now let me go back to type, because type is actually the most important cell, and that's one we need to look at carefully now. In Project 2013, there are basically three types of resource, and I want to look at each of those types now. There are some alternative approaches to costs and budgeting, which sort of lead you to a fourth type of resource, but it isn't really a different type of resource at all. We'll talk about that briefly later on. The three types of resource are work, material, and cost. And for the purposes of this introduction, we'll think of work as the people that are working on our project, that are building our house. So it will be people like the bricklayers, the labourers, the plasterers, the painters, and so on. Materials are the resources that get consumed in the building of the house. So this will be things like bricks, window frames, concrete, cement, mortar, and so on. Cost typically is other costs. An example of a cost might be an account that's used for various expenses on the project. So we might have a pool, or what in the UK would be called a petty cash account, where we might put travel expenses in there. Now the way that these three different types are used within Microsoft Project are actually quite different, and particularly when we get to the area of working out costs, the way that the three of them work is very different. Let's just stick with work for the moment. Our bricklayer as a person is a type of work resource, and if you look over to those cost fields that I mentioned just now, you can see that we have a standard rate, so a certain number of dollars per hour that we pay a bricklayer, and then we have an overtime rate, a certain number of dollars per hour that we pay on overtime, extra time rate. We also have another cost figure, which is cost per use, which is usually an additional cost we may have to pay one-off to use this resource. Now when you're talking about a bricklayer, there may not be an additional cost per use, but you might also use a work resource type for something like a piece of digging equipment. So you may have to hire a piece of digging equipment. Maybe it's going to cost $50 an hour while you're doing the work on preparing the site. And there may be a cost per use. For example, a cost for the supplier of the digging equipment to deliver it to your site and collect it again at the end, which is a one-off additional cost. Now, the whole area of costs we're going to look at later on, but I just wanted to point out to you there that when you're looking at work resources, the costs are, generally speaking, are based on the amount of time that something works on your project, with the possible addition of a cost per use figure as well. Now let's set up a material type of resource, and the material type of resource that I'm going to set up are bricks. So I'll type in bricks. This is a material resource. Watch what happens when I select material to the other fields that have been filled in there on the resource sheet. You notice that what the default values are changes. The standard rate is no longer per hour. The standard rate is the cost. There's no overtime rate. There is a cost per use. Accrue. I'll talk about accruals later. But I'm going to put here as the initials bricks. And now I'm going to talk about this cell, this field here, material. Now, I tend to think that that field name there, material, isn't a particularly helpful field name, because what that field actually represents is the units of measure of the material. Now in the case of bricks, we're going to talk about bricks in thousands. So my unit of measure is going to be that, thousands. I could put the word thousands. In fact, you can put anything you like in that field as long as it makes clear what the units of measure are. So in a typical house, I might use, say, around 10,000 to 15,000 bricks, which means that this particular material, bricks, if I wanted 12,000 bricks, I would say 12 of this resource, because this resource is 1,000 bricks. Now, I'm not actually going to put any costs in there at the moment. We're going to come back to costs a little bit later on. But let me just point out a couple of other things. If I say select the bricks line and double click, I come up with a resource information dialog, a bit like the task information dialog, but this has got basically all of the information you need about a specific resource. Different tabs, general, costs, notes, custom fields, we'll look at many of these later on in the course. One of the things to note here that when you're dealing with, say, costs, is that you can show rate changes over time. So if over a particular period of time the cost of something is going to go up or down or increase by a percentage, you can cover that within the resource information here. So when it comes to things like costing, Microsoft Project is pretty powerful in terms of what you can do. Now we'll come back to the resource information dialog in quite a bit more detail later on. Now, in the next section, we're going to look at assigning these resources to the tasks within our project. But now you've got your first exercise to do yourself. I'm going to save this project as it is now as example 3.0.3 in the supplied files. And what I want you to do is to add some additional resources using the resource sheet. Now, the terminology you use may be different. It's absolutely not a problem, depending on your locale. You may call a person that deals with wood in a building a joiner or a carpenter, depending on where you are. And you may use an abbreviation like a chippy for a joiner. But I'd like you to add, as work type resources, a carpenter or a joiner. And I'd like you to add as material resources windows and doors. So one resource is a window, it'll be a single unit, and one resource will be a door, again a door, single unit. Don't worry about putting in the costs, the prices in there. My answer to that question is in example file 4, and that's going to be our starting point for the next section, so please join me for that.